Well, welcome everybody. Today I thought it'd be fun to share with you what I have in my pantry as some of my staple items that I use on a weekly basis. Now, these are items that are more non-perishable. If you want to see what's in my fridge, what I have on hand, what I do for groceries, definitely let me know in the comments. But I have done some grocery hauls, so I'll put those in the description box for you if you're interested in those. But I'm going to share with you my items that I use very regularly, and some of them I'll share the brands as well. So, pantry is an important place for me as I am a homemaker. I love cooking. I need plenty of these items in my stock house for when I cook meals for my family. So first things, these are in no particular order, are oils. I use coconut oil all the time. I use olive oil all the time as well. And so for coconut oil, I had been getting an unrefined coconut oil from Walmart, actually, that's like in a 52-ounce canister, but they no longer ship it. I do a lot of shipping because I don't live close to a large store. And it is an organic, unrefined, virgin coconut oil. Right now, I simply have the Aldi brand coconut oil that is organic as well. That has worked just fine too. And then an olive oil, I just buy a nice big canister of that as well. All right, we always have salsas on hand because we do like Mexican in our house. And so I just buy the Aldi brand of salsa. We do medium or mild. Sometimes we do the other like pineapple mixes of salsa. And this I don't buy organic, to each his own, but here I have not. And I always have three or four of those stocked in my pantry. Then we have pasta or marinara sauces. Yes, I could make my own with all the tomatoes that I get in the summer months, but it just doesn't last long enough for all the work you go to. A pasta sauce from Aldi, a good brand, is like $1.80, $2, so not too bad. And I like the ones with lower sugar or the organic brand as well. We always have a good natural peanut butter on hand. I love my peanut butter. If I have a snack, it's like a homemade muffin with some peanut butter on it. I am a sucker for peanut butter. So we were getting the Smucker's peanut butter again from Walmart because they were selling them 2 for $8, the nice 32 ounces. And then again, they quit doing that as well. So now I'm on the hunt for a good natural peanut butter. So if you know any, let me know. But the problem is, I know Costco has a really good brand. We don't have a Costco membership. Maybe that's something we need to invest in just so we can get some good quality, natural organic items as well. And so right now I have some Aldi brand natural peanut butter, or there's from ordering it from Walmart as well, but it's a natural peanut butter as well. We always have honey and maple syrup as our sweeteners, so I will not go without having honey in my stock house. And then maple syrup, those are just great additions to your oatmeal when I'm baking, and I like using those over the refined sugars. Speaking of sweeteners, I always have a cane sugar or a coconut sugar, just a brand, organic brand from Walmart, their brand that I order online. I always have flour. I do wheat flour for my sourdough starter and a lot of other dishes that I make that call for flour. And I also have einkorn flour that I've been implementing into my items that I bake more often. And I actually get that from Young Living, as I am Young Living advocate, and I do have the ability to sell it as well. And then I do just have some plain old white flour for making items to take to events, because a lot of people around where I live don't really know what einkorn flour is, and white flour is what they're more commonly used. So I also have oats. I will not go without rolled oats, and I also have some steel cut oats. Potatoes, onions, garlic, those are a lot of items that are from my garden. And so I definitely have those type of items on stock, and I still need to dig up a couple more rows of my potatoes. So I will have a stock house full through several more months, if I store them correctly, of the potatoes and onions. And then canned or frozen tomatoes. I do freeze some of our tomatoes and have some canned as well. If not, I will buy some from Aldi, just like a crushed or whole tomato from Aldi that I will get. Okay, this is something, a few more things that I do myself. Jams. I always have some sort of a jam on hand. Right now I probably have 20 or 30 jars of the pint or smaller, like half pint jars of different jams that I've made throughout the last year, like peach, let's see, strawberry rhubarb, just rhubarb, apple, butter also is another staple that I've canned. So just having those on hand is something that we like to have on our pancakes or that we have, my husband has every morning on his toast. Also pickles. I canned pickles all summer, so we have plenty of pickles. If we ever do run out, I will just buy a nice natural pickle, as many of them do have dyes in them if they aren't a good quality pickle. I also will make sure to have dry beans on hand, and I will have some canned sometimes just because of the convenience factor. It's nice to have some canned beans for a quick something if you forgot. Although the Instant Pot, if you follow my cook with me, works really quickly for cooking up dry beans to use in a dish. Then I also always have a rice or a quinoa and some sort of a pasta, like a whole wheat spaghetti pasta. I do have just plain old enriched pasta as well, because sometimes you have to have those for go-tos. And then rice, we usually have a long grain brown rice or a jasmine rice for more of an oriental style dish. Then I always have sea salt. Now this is my favorite sea salt. It's Redmond sea salt. A friend got me hooked on this, and I make sure I have that in bulk. So I often, a lot of these things are in bulk. I wanna make sure I have plenty. So peanut butter, I'll have 3 jars on hand just to make sure, because like I said, we don't live close to a place with these items. So I wanna make sure I have plenty of these items on hand for when the need arises to use them. And then another must for me is our coffee. Now I do have a friend pick up the Kirkland brand coffee from Costco for us in the whole bean medium roast, because that is one of the best. It is a Starbucks, roasted by Starbucks actually. So it's really a really good bean, and we love that in our French press. And so coffee, tea, I guess we have lots of teas. So those aren't really things I cook with, but I must have coffee. Definitely have to have the coffee. So those are pretty much all our pantry staples that are go-to for me that I have a lot. Oh, I guess I should mention, like, a vinegar and an apple cider vinegar are something that I do have on hand often. And apple cider vinegar I use more than the actually white vinegar for cooking aspects. But those are a lot of my main pantry staples that I have in my pantry here in our storage downstairs. They are things we eat on a weekly basis, things that I have to have on hand in order to make meals for my family. So maybe that will encourage you to find some things that you maybe are forgetting or you would like to add to your stock house for, especially these winter months. It's nice to just kind of stock up a little bit. I am not a hoarder. I don't have an overabundance of items, but I do like to have plenty on hand. Anyways, I hope you are enjoying your day, and have a blessed and wonderful day. Talk with you in my next video.